Imagine addressing the tragedy of losing a woman every 2 minutes. What better story would you have?
Ian Frazer arrived from Scotland 25 years ago. Today, he's Australian of the Year. He developed a vaccine for cervical cancer, which kills 250,000 women worldwide each year.
And that was always my interest, was understanding why some people can't get rid of virus infections. But this was a very significant virus because it can trigger a cancer, and therefore it seemed like a good one to focus on to try and study and understand why some people get rid of viruses and other people can't. To make a vaccine against a virus, normally you grow up the virus and either kill it or render it less dangerous and then use that as the vaccine. Papillomavirus is an annoying virus because we can't grow it in the lab. We had to wait until the techniques of genetic engineering came along, and then my colleague Jan Zhu and I, we found a way of building the shell of the virus, and it was the shell of the virus that has become the vaccine.
An HPV vaccine, which could become as widely used as the vaccine for rubella.
This is potentially a vaccine which could be administered to all young people around the world.
Yes, it is a race, let's face it.
We've delivered over 200 million doses of the vaccine worldwide. In Australia, this vaccine is paid for by the government and made available to all boys and girls between the age of 12 and 14 through schools. Globally, the vaccine is not so widely available. In some countries you have to buy it, in other countries it's simply not available at all. And in the developing world, it really relies on charitable donations to get vaccine into the country. The challenge, of course, is to get universal immunisation. If we had a successful immunisation programme, we could not only prevent the cancers, but eventually eliminate the virus entirely. There needs to be a global initiative to get rid of papillomavirus infection. It needs to start from the top, start from the World Health Organization that are very keen to achieve this. It then needs to flow down through the aid agencies to make sure that the vaccine is available in the countries where cervical cancer is common, such as sub-Saharan Africa and indeed many of the developing world countries. The Cancer Council of Australia, through the individual state cancer councils, has sponsored research into how to prevent cervical cancer over many years.
So from a Cancer Council perspective, the identification of the vaccine in Australia meant that we were at the forefront of being able to lobby government to get girls vaccinated. And we know that as school participation rises in low-income countries, vaccination opportunities will also increase. And that provides a great opportunity for not only cervical cancer, but for also broader cancer and chronic disease awareness.
Vaccines have been the single most effective means of preventing avoidable deaths, of extending life across the planet. It's really sad to see that people should go out there and not protect their children against these infections. There is no reason why people should be worried about vaccines. They are safe, they're proven effective. Australia has led the way in cervical cancer prevention right from the beginning. We started by immunising all the girls back in 2007. In 2012, we added in a programme so that all boys were immunised as well. The impact of this globally is that we can now demonstrate to the world at large how effective the vaccines actually are, because the burden of disease caused by these papillomaviruses in Australia has just disappeared over the course of the last 10 years. And we are now seriously thinking that cervical cancer will simply be gone from Australia by 2028.
We have the vaccines, we have the diagnostics, and we have the treatment. When we have all the weapons at hand, failure should not be an option.
I strongly believe that with collective effort, we can eradicate papillomavirus infection. It will take a while to do that, but if we can deliver 200 million doses of vaccine in 10 years, we can immunize the whole population over the next 30 or 40 years and reasonably expect that within my children's lifetime, we'll have no more cervical cancer.